All right, camera is set. Here we go. It's the first one. So I think I finally found an app that will allow me to do this where I can record and I also can look and view in real time the video of me performing a workout. So the purpose and plan of this is two things. One, selfishly, I want to be able to critique, break down, and kind of walk you guys through how I look at my workouts and how I think I can improve myself for the open season and quarterfinals and maybe semifinals. That's the goal. And then competing in general in other competitions. As the goal for 2024, so next year, is to compete in probably half a dozen CrossFit competitions. So right now I only do about two a year. Typically it's Invictus Boston. Last year I did Invictus and Metcon Rush. So we're going to add three or four more competitions within my season to really prime and prep me for semifinals and get me experience there and really see if I can push my limits and figure out what I need to do as a competitor moving in maybe into the 2025 season. So thinking long term, this is the first step. So let's get into the video. Here we go. So this is the third set of three. The clock started at what, 10:08? I'm just gonna take some notes here and walk you guys through them going through. So 10:08, time starts. It is a 20 cal echo bike. And on this one, I'm ripping it at probably about an 85 RPM. In the previous two intervals, I was a little bit more conservative, holding about an 80 because I didn't know how this was gonna feel and how this was gonna impact me. The total workout itself is a 20 cal echo bike. It is a one peg board. It is then 20 wall balls, two rope climbs, and then 20 GHD sit-ups. So the average time on the bike in the first two intervals was around 45 to 50-ish some seconds. This one was again in that lower end of 45. The pegboard, quick transition, I think that was about 5 seconds that we got into that. It's about 12 to 15 seconds to get up and down on the pegboard. Really smooth. I had a couple mishaps with the hands coming down, but nothing too crazy. Again, the interval itself is not super intense. So, I don't know if I'm hitting depth on these wall balls. So that's another good reason to record too, is looking at this. That was definitely a no rep. So these wall balls are very hairline, like they might count in a competition. Also the camera angle from it being up a little bit could throw it off. But for the most part, I don't know if I'm hitting depth on these 20 wall balls. And so the weight and target, so it's to a 10-foot target and 20 pounds for me. For ladies, it would be 14 pounds. But I am not happy with those wall balls. My feet are very, very wide, which I guess I was just thinking about speed and not taking in the technical aspect of putting my feet together. They can go together and I can squat deeper. So that is something to notice. With this rope, it is not a true 15-foot, 16-foot rope, whatever it is. So I don't jump to accommodate for the two pulls that I would do if I could jump and hit the proper height and depth on this rope. Also, side note, if you look at my left leg, I have a knee sleeve on. I forgot my rope cover, so we had to adapt and move there. Also, not good dismount. Rope wrapped me up completely. And as we're pushing into this final third of the interval itself, or the third and final interval, the GHDs, this cadence was much quicker on the back half than the first two intervals. So like these were kind of just catching your breath real quick. And then the last 10, we really just kind of closed our eyes and hammered them out. And I think this interval in total was just under 3 minutes. I'm going to show you guys after this workout a breakdown of what my times were, what my splits were, and a full just layout of the workout with the camera. But in this, we're just trying to move with a little bit of pace, hold back just a tad, probably go about an 8 out of 10 effort on each one, not like a full send sprint, but around three-ish minutes was the goal, and we hit that on each mark, progressively getting faster with each set. The volume and intensity wasn't anything that was crazy. It didn't crush me, so I was pretty happy with this because this was the first Metcon that I've done since the 12 Days of Christmas WOD. Again, the workout is up on the board, writing in and filling in my final time. Looking to finish, I think it was like, what, 13? Yeah, 13:04 on the dot. So again, that is 2:56. The other two were 3:02, and then I believe a 3:06. So pretty consistently there, moving. I wish the second interval may have been a little faster, but my transitions were probably a little bit slower, took time to breathe. But overall, pretty happy with how this one broke down. I hope you guys enjoyed this first one. I'm going to see how this edits, but I think I did find a software, and I'm pretty, pretty happy with it. So thank you guys for watching this breakdown. And as always, peace, much love.